Wow, I didn't see this one coming. I mean, I saw the trailers constantly for the last few months, just like everybody else did, and I bet a lot of people arrived at the same assumption I did. Decent-looking middle-brow thriller whose trailer was probably giving away way too much of the plot. Well, surprise, turns out the reason they were advertising so much is the movie is actually real good. And it also turns out that the trailers are barely giving away anything. Prisoners is a lot bigger, a lot more complex, and a lot darker than they've been selling. Which brings up the perennial problem of how far to trend into spoiler territory when reviewing a movie like this. My outlook has fluctuated, to say the least, on this subject, but I think I'm starting to form a solid stance on things. Basically, I think it's bad form to give away things that are supposed to be surprises within the plot, i.e. things that are surprising to the characters in the movie. But beyond that, given the choice between delivering a muddled, ineffective review and discussing the plot in ways that might lessen the impact of certain scenes compared to going in cold, yeah, I'm gonna have to talk about the plot. No spoilers, some details, fair warning, but that should kind of be implicit since Prisoners is a detective movie, a mystery. Our story, two neighboring families, one working class comprised of Hugh Jackman and Maria Bello, the other more well-to-do consisting of Terrence Howard and Viola Davis, get together for Thanksgiving. After dinner, their respective young daughters go outside for a walk and vanish without a trace. Abduction is suspected, but there's no evidence, and the only even remotely viable suspect is a mentally handicapped young man who can barely speak and seems incapable of kidnapping or hurting anybody. In the midst of his investigation, Jake Gyllenhaal's Detective Loki stumbles onto a potentially bigger crime that may or may not be connected, and all the while the families get more and more desperate. Until strung-out dad Hugh Jackman decides it's time to take matters into his own hands, kidnapping the now-freed original suspect and imprisoning him with the intent to torture him until he confesses. That much you already know from the trailers. What the ads have been hiding is that it's only about one-third of the actual story. While Jackman is cycling through increasingly inhuman attempts at jack-bowering answers out of his captive, Detective Loki is uncovering hints of crime and conspiracy that start to look less and less like the starkly realistic police procedural we began with, and more like a morbidly elaborate horror show out of Thomas Harris or Stieg Larsson. That would appear to be Prisoner's foundational diabolical hook. What if one of those preposterously depraved potboiler setups you'd expect to find in the ultra-stylized world of, say, Criminal Minds, you know, full of twists and clues and symbols and horrifyingly evil bad guys with implausibly convoluted motivations for their elaborate sadistic methods, happened in an otherwise real world to otherwise real people who reacted, well, realistically? The answer, according to Prisoners, nothing good. Movies about people enduring ghastly tragedy are always about personal transformation, finding out what you're made of when it counts, that sort of thing, but most of the time there's at least one person who rises to the occasion and proves their mettle. Here, no such luck. Nobody gets to be the hero. The four parents all descend into various levels of moral compromise, self-destruction, and even outright evil because, hey, sometimes that's what grief does, it breaks you. Meanwhile, Detective Loki struggles mightily against a case that could probably use a Sherlock Holmes, a Bobby Gorin, or a Horatio Caine-style mastermind when he's just an ordinary, realistic cop. Not stupid, not brilliant, just ordinary. But then the film isn't really about the mystery to begin with. It's about what these kind of events do to a person. Frankly, it wasn't that hard for me to suss out who the bad guy was and what was really going on fairly in the proceedings, but honestly, that's true of almost any movie like this. Just ask yourself if there were any characters, items, or biographical details in the first half of the story that don't seem to have a reason to exist other than to turn out to be important later, and you can figure out pretty much any Hollywood detective movie. But Prisoners seems to know this, and that the point isn't the destination, but the journey. And that journey is about as dark, challenging, and emotionally grueling as mainstream movies are allowed to get these days. The actors are all in reliable top form, but it's Jackman who has the big, showy, complex, what else do I have to do to get an Oscar already role at the center of the storm. He's ingeniously cast given the superhero baggage he brings with him to the role, since the story sets him up from the first scene as the kind of guy who in a lesser, dumber, pandering version of this story would unquestionably be the hero. The bearded, blue-collar, deer-hunting, working-class badass with a Jesus fish on his pickup truck, a survivalist stockpile in his cellar, the skills to rig up a one-man Guantanamo Bay, and the righteous sense of purpose to use it. And hey, this routine works for the dads in Taken and 24, right? Except this film isn't really interested in visceral thrills or jump scares. Its stock in trade is putting the audience through the ringer by drawing out the time between the audience knowing something and the characters knowing something as long as it can. And as a result, we pick up on the idea that this guy has turned the wrong moral corner a long time before the pieces start falling into place of just how wrong he really is. Of all Prisoner's nasty curveballs to the audience, this is easily the harshest. A methodical, bloody deconstruction of the cherished American myth of the hyper-competent, ever-capable father figure, stripping away the cultural paint job until the alleged badass is revealed as nothing more than a brute who's only good at making things worse. It's a tremendous achievement of both Jackman and the screenplay to be able to take this guy from the most sympathetic position possible all the way around to a total monster and have it remain compelling and believable. It works so well that it helps the film itself overcome the inevitable missteps that come from this kind of ambition. The twisty plot and devilish use of ticking time bomb tension can't quite make the mix of stock human realism and schlock horror sensationalism gel coherently, and while its longer than average running time is helpful in connecting the audience with the anxious desperation of the characters, it's not hard to get impatient during a second act detour involving a red herring so elaborate it can't help but call attention to itself as a red herring. Still, those minor issues are just that, minor issues. Where it counts in terms of human drama, however contrived, and dramatic tension, however manipulative, Prisoners is a real winner, one of the better movies you can see in theaters right now. See you next time.